I was happy to know what was wrong with me, because it's like he said, we can fix that. Well, not fix it, but it's like we can deal with it and do stuff and we can try all this stuff. And I was like, oh, good. Because for a long time I'd had people telling me, it's all in your mind. You're making it up. It's not real. Or just get over it. At school, I didn't really talk to my friends about what was fully wrong with me. Like, they knew I was sick. You could not tell. But I didn't really tell them because I was really embarrassed about it. Like, I didn't want to tell them that I was having constant diarrhea. I had a school nurse tell me to get over it one day. I had a teacher at school refused to let me go to the bathroom, but then she ended up letting me go. And 2 weeks later, I left that school.
And one of my realizations one day was I took Alex to school and I saw 1,000 girls from school all walking there at once and realised how hard it was for her and how hard to fit into a world where everything is 9 to 5, it's controlled. And that was the point. I thought, this school isn't right for you anymore.
To get into where I am now, my biggest challenge has probably just been getting to where I am now. I had 10 years of not being healthy. I've had surgeries, multiple surgeries. I've been on every medication that they have for this. And it wasn't until the one that I'm on now that I actually had any real success.
I'm really, really pleased that Alex is working. And she's actually working more than she has in the past. She's been able to get through university. But you still get very concerned about what's going to happen in the future.
I can remember having a sketchbook with coloured pencils and just started drawing, and I ended up doing a degree in fine art. So I can remember that in the start of my realising that art was a very healing process as well, and something I really enjoyed. Mm-hmm. So it was something that I really connected to, and I don't think I would have gone down that path if I hadn't been Crohn's, because I probably would have maybe gone a different way. In February I went to Europe for 6 weeks, and if you'd asked me, you know, 5 years ago, would I be ever travelling overseas, I would have said no. So it's one of those things that while my health is good, I will use it to my advantage. But there's always that fear in the back of your mind that you'll get sick again. But I feel that if I did get sick again now, I'm very much able to cope with it. Like, I know what to do. To teenagers or kids going through this, I would say embrace it. Don't be embarrassed by your body, because everybody poops. There's a book written about it. And yes, it can be embarrassing, especially when you're a teenager and you don't even know who you are yet. And there's this thing that is so much of your identity. Because I know when I was a teenager and I was diagnosed with Crohn's, even into my early 20s, that was so much a part of my identity. Don't be afraid to not let that be your identity. It is part of you, but it's not who you are. You are not defined by your disease.
I have Crohn's. Crohn's doesn't have me.